Hello and welcome. Today we are going to learn how to connect mobile without using any USB cable or any cable to our computer or laptop and connecting it through a Wi-Fi. So let's get started, and I have also written down the steps here. Step number one is we have to ensure that the computer and the mobile phone are connected over the same Wi-Fi network. So your computer or your laptop and your mobile device should be connected to the same Wi-Fi. The second step is connect mobile with computer using cable. So at this moment, you can connect your mobile device with your computer system using the cable. And now you will run ADB devices on the command line. So I'm on Mac, I will go to terminal. If you are on Windows, you can go to your command line and run ADB devices, and this should show you the list of device attached. And also please make sure that when you connect your mobile with a cable, in case you get a prompt to enable USB debugging, you have to enable that, and then when you run ADB devices, you will be getting the list of devices attached. Now this ADB devices command will run only when you have SDK, and all this we have learned in the earlier sessions. So just in case you are facing some issue with this command ADB devices, you can watch the earlier sessions. So you should be getting your device ID here, and then now on the command line you have to run the command ADP TCP IP and the port 5555. Now you can use any other port as well. In case this port 5555 is already used or busy, you can use some other port. So I will just go here and say ADB TCP IP 5555, and it is saying restarting TCP port 5555. Now just in case you face an issue, you can say ADB kill server, and it will stop the server, and then you can again start ADB TCP IP 5555. So you can see now it is saying daemon started successfully. And then here you can now disconnect your mobile with the cable. So you can disconnect the cable from your mobile, and now you can go to your mobile and then get the IP of your mobile. So I will just show you on my mobile device how to do that. If I show you my mobile screen here, so I'm using a program called Visor, and with the help of Visor, I'm able to show you my mobile screen on this laptop. So this is my real device, real mobile, which is connected to the system. And I will go to settings, and I will go to about phone, and here I will go to status, and here you can see I have the IP here. Now just in case you are not seeing the IP, you can check online with your device specific name that where you can get the IP, what is the settings where you can get the IP. So this is 192.168.1.4. So this is let me just go and say this here. This is 192.168.1.4. this is the IP of my mobile. And now once you have got the IP, in step number 6 we will run this command ADB connect and the IP of the mobile phone. So on the command line I will just say ADB connect 192.168.1.4, and here I'm getting a error or this message, missing port in specification. So in case you also get this, you can do ADL server and then again try to start and connect, or you can also say, I will say ADB kill hyphen server, and then I will say ADB connect to the IP. So this should be the IP of the mobile. I will just copy the same IP here as well and here. So now I will say ADB connect, and I will give the IP along with the port number. So I will say this ADB connect, and let us say now, and yes, it is saying daemon started successfully, connected to this IP and port. And now after this, if you are able to see this message, you can use your mobile without cable. So even if I remove the cable and I will say ADB devices, and you can see it is showing me the list of devices attached. So as of now, I have not connected my mobile device with the cable to the computer system, but still I am getting this. The difference here you will see is Earlier, when the device was connected with a USB cable, the ID here, it was something different, but now it is showing a different ID. So this is a IP and the port. And now I can do automation on this device without connecting it with a USB cable. And if I go to Appium, if I start Appium on my system, I can connect to this device and I can also, I'll just show you. So Appium is starting. And once it is started, we will go to the desired capabilities and then we will give this particular value in the UDID and try to start our calculator application. So let's just wait for Appium to get started. And yes, it is started. I will say start server and I will go to this start inspector session. And we have learned this in the earlier session as well. So I will just go to the saved capabilities. And if you see, this was something I saved earlier, which is the desired capabilities of the same mobile device when I had connected it through the cable. And this is the UDID. So I'm just going to copy this. And I can create a new, or let me just make changes here. So instead of this UDID, I will provide a UDID, this one. And I will say save here. And then I will say start session. So this should start the calculator application. So you can see the app package and app activity is of calculator application. We have learned all this in the earlier sessions. So this should start the mobile device, connect to the mobile device and start the calculator application. And you can see it is starting. And yes, the calculator application is here. So this is how you can connect your mobile device with your computer without a USB cable through Wi-Fi. I hope this session was useful for you. Thank you for watching.